This is the Tourbox Elite Plus, a shortcut controller designed to speed up your creative tasks. The previous models have been amazing for my digital painting process on PC, but now, with this iPad-compatible version, I can seamlessly continue my work even when I'm on the move. Let's take a closer look. Hey, Ryan here. So with the kind of work that I do and traveling around with my work, I tend to bounce around between devices quite a bit. Of course, the drawing experience between those can be quite different even if I'm drawing in the same app. I generally tackle more serious painting on my laptop, where I can more comfortably spread out with a multi-monitor setup, and where I've been using other models of Tourbox. Switching over to the iPad though, even though I'm drawing and painting in the same app, I feel slower and I can't work the same way that I'm used to when I'm sitting at my computer. But now that transition is becoming more seamless, less disruptive, thanks to the Tourbox Elite Plus, which the Tourbox team sent over for me to review. So let's see what we actually have here in case you're not familiar with it. The Tourbox Elite Plus is housed in this translucent matte plastic, giving you a sense of the hardware inside. There's a scroll wheel, knob, and dial along with 11 buttons, including this one on the side. But also, these can be pressed down as well, so we could say there are 14 buttons. The way they're placed and the shape of them makes it really easy to know what button you're hitting, which is great for building your muscle memory. Around the back, we have a USB-C port for using this wired with a computer. And underneath, rubber feet in the corners, a power switch, Bluetooth pairing button, and in here we have two AA batteries for using this via Bluetooth. One set should get you about 1 to 2 months, depending on how you use it. The build quality feels really good, it's sturdy, and the size and weight is pretty much exactly the same as the standard Elite version. Compared with the keyboard, this takes up less space and is just nicer to use. Everything is right here under my hand, no dancing around on a wider keyboard. And when it comes to functionality, the Tourbox can just do so much more than what shortcut remotes can from Wacom or Huion, for example. But to explain that part, it's best to just jump into the software. On the App Store, you'll find the Tourbox Console app, where you'll be able to customize all the buttons and dials and whatnot. There are a few presets for popular apps like Clip Studio Paint, Procreate, Final Cut Pro, but if your app is not listed and it has keyboard shortcuts available, you can create your own preset. I'm using Magma for most of my drawing and painting, and it's quite rich in the way of keyboard shortcuts, so I know I can get a lot out of this. Swiping to the left brings up the buttons panel, but I can also simply press the button or turn the dial that I want to customize, and it'll immediately jump to that here. That makes the whole setup process pretty easy. Looking at the dials and the wheel, these can either be set to simulating gestures, perform system actions, or keyboard shortcuts, like the bracket keys for my brush size. They also have haptic feedback, which can be adjusted per dial. Initially, I wasn't all that interested in haptics, but it's actually grown on me quite a bit. For the buttons, you can assign keyboard shortcuts to a single press of the button, but there are actually various different button modes well beyond the simple down press. AB mode is quite interesting, where you can set one action to the down press and then another action on the release. To show you, I've been experimenting with this workflow. The down press is set to my lasso selection. Then while holding that, I draw out a shape. When I release, it switches over to my brush. Then I can fill that area in with my texture brushes while keeping a nice sharp edge. Then there's loop, which is a pretty new feature, where you can cycle between up to 4 different shortcuts. It's not a bad way to switch between tools like your brush and eraser. It could use some improving though, because if you use a different button in the middle of a loop, it resets the loop rather than continuing to the next thing when you press it again. The real power of Tourbox lies in the button combinations. This is what sets it apart from other controllers, and it's what initially sold me on Tourbox in the first place. This dial, on its own, is for making my brush bigger or smaller, right? But when I hold down this button on the side, and then turn the dial, it adjusts the opacity of my brush. If instead I pair the dial with this button, I can change the rotation of my brush, which is great for flatter brushes. The same goes for the buttons. This on its own is for my eyedropper, because on iPad, I don't really like having to long press with my finger to pick colors. A button and tap with the pen just feels better for me. When I combine it with that side button again, it switches my two selected colors. And one more thing, buttons can have shortcuts assigned to the double press as well. So with that same button, double press resets my colors to black and white. With these combos, I can group actions together quite efficiently, and they're a lot easier to memorize. The D-pad on its own I use for switching tools, but when I engage that side button and combine it with the D-pad, I get my layer actions. So you really get a lot of options here. The buttons on their own, button combinations for unique shortcuts, buttons with dials, double press, and the various button modes. Now this mainly shows the more obvious button options, but if the combination you want isn't listed, you can just scroll to the bottom to create a custom action. Something to keep in mind if you're working across multiple apps, unlike on computer where the presets will automatically switch when you change between applications, on the iPad you have to do this manually in Tourbox Console. So what is it like to actually draw and paint with this on the iPad? It's just as good as what I'm used to with it on computer, to be honest. It responds immediately, there's no weird delay. Even though I use the same software to draw and paint both on PC and iPad, switching to the iPad often had me working in a different way because I didn't have the same tools and space available, which would slow me down a bit. I could grab a slim wireless keyboard, but sometimes that takes up an awkward space and I would just end up saving more serious painting for when I got back to my computer and I had my more comfortable setup. But with this, I have it set up exactly the same way for iPad as I do on computer. So now when I head out for a change of scenery or I need a more compact setup while I'm traveling, the switch is now more seamless. I can still work exactly the same way that I'm used to no matter which device I'm on, minus the larger display. The same would go for something like Clip Studio Paint or maybe even DaVinci Resolve, though I haven't tried video editing on the iPad yet. And because the Tourbox Elite Plus can have up to two Bluetooth connections, I can press this button on the back to switch connections quickly if I just want to test something out on another device. I already have a video on the standard Elite version, so if you are curious about using this with PC, rather than repeat myself too much here, I'll link that video at the end of this one. I do want to mention some differences though. First, that loop mode I mentioned is only available on the iPad version of console at the moment. Second, overlay elements like the heads-up display or the custom tour menu, these aren't available on iPad. This is only for computer. Then setting macros are a thing for computer, but not for iPad. And also the repeat button mode while held down is only for computer too. So if you are using a Tourbox already and thinking to switch to this one to use on the iPad, this is something to keep in mind. I definitely recommend joining the growing Tourbox community over on Reddit. If you have questions about a specific model of Tourbox, or if you're curious about whether or not this is going to work with your preferred app or workflow. The way a Tourbox feels to use, being more like a video game controller, but for art with its unique button variation and placement and button combinations, I love it. Memorizing my shortcuts and hitting the right ones when I intend to feels a lot easier here than on some other controllers which have more same shape, same feel buttons. And now having all of this over on iPad for my semi-nomadic self, it's great. There is a minor inconvenience though if you don't plan for it, and that has to do with the batteries. It can only pair with the iPad over Bluetooth and not via cable, so if my batteries run flat while I'm on the move, that might disrupt my work a little bit if I didn't pack in any spares, just something to keep in mind. So what would I still like to see come from Tourbox? I suppose maybe a dark mode for the Tourbox console app because I'm often working indoors and late at night. Hopefully we'll see that loop mode come over to the computer version of console. And what about Android compatibility? Because the button settings are synced directly to the Tourbox here, if they're set to keyboard keys, I can actually pair this with my Galaxy tab and use it there. However, you will always need an iPad to make changes to the settings. I assume the majority of the professional creative market on mobile are probably on iPad, but maybe one day we'll see console come over to Android. On that note, who is this for actually? Because at just under $300, it's a lot to spend for an accessory, right? But it is much more than that. This is a workflow enhancer. With the level of functionality that this has, and we're talking well over 100 different button combos and different inputs here, this is best suited to a professional for whom the iPad is their primary creation tool to make getting stuff done smoother and faster. And if you tend to bounce around between computer and iPad, especially if using the same applications, even better. For myself, I do wonder if it is a bit overkill for my needs as a digital painter with a relatively simple workflow and tool set. But playing around with the light recently, there are definitely some things that I miss, which I'll get into in another video. So what about those who don't need this level of functionality? The more casual painter, the younger user. There is the 8-bit Do Micro, which for a tenth of the price does a pretty good job at covering some of my most used shortcuts. There are a couple of other remotes that are compatible with the iPad too, but I want those button combinations. So what if Tourbox managed something in the middle? A mobile compatible version of the Lite perhaps? I think that would be amazing, but I'd love to know what you think. Drop me a comment down below. I'm gonna get back to painting. Ciao for now.